Mandera Governor Ali Roba is at this moment appearing before the Senate County Public Accounts Committee to answer to audit queries relating to the 2014-2015 financial year. We now want to cross over to the Senate and listen in.
Indeed, there has been fiscal responsibility in this particular county beyond the issues of...
Once he's done with his remarks...
And before the Auditor General comes in, Governor, are you therefore making a request that the government should consider formally reopening the border?
Absolutely. Actually, I did that severally in press statement I've released. President of Somalia was here. He made a similar request to the President of Kenya. And some goodwill has appeared of the will by the government to open the border. We just want to request an appeal that the border be opened, because it will have more than trade impact, because the flow of human intelligence is also going to be embedded in the movement of goods and people through a regulated customs border rather than porous border. And that will really go a long way in also enhancing our security and also quality of the goods that come through. Thank you.
Thank you. The committee takes note of that. Senator Fatuma Dulo, I know you sit in the Defense and Foreign Affairs Committee, and you still sit there, I believe so. And I believe that that is a matter that your committee can deliberate on and advise the House on the way forward. It is beyond the mandate of this committee.
I think, Chair, before maybe I comment on the border, the issue of the equalization fund. I remember I mentioned this in the FCDC meeting, where a senator has also explained some few minutes ago that Senate has no say in terms of the formula that was presented to us, and we told them as much, because we cannot be used as a rubber stamp. This is the formula, you must go by it. We must have a say in it. And I think if we don't have an avenue where we can be able to change the position, then it means they will proceed and implement it. So my appeal to you as FCDC chair and also a member of Council of Governors, you need to further that discussion, maybe up to the political level, and also National Assembly, because I remember in the last parliament, National Assembly actually twisted Senate and took up the responsibility of managing equalization fund. And as a Senate, we are not even happy the way it's being handled, because the way the projects are even implemented is not right, because public participation is not done properly, and the counties have no say. It's just a matter of PR exercise actually that took place, especially where I come from, and the proposal made by members of public were not even considered. So I think, and I'm seeing maybe there could be a challenge even in the third formula of CRA that is going to come up, if things are not going to be changed in the manner that Senate is proposing the change to take place, then we are having a lot of problem. So I would urge you, maybe we can put our heads together as a Senate and also Council of Governors and see how we can intervene, because that is not right. As Senator for Mandera has said, the arrears is still standing. So we don't see why that money is being held, and yet we need that money like yesterday. So I think we have to move with speed that is required to make sure that that formula is actually changed. Secondly, on the issue of security, I think I remember we went to Mandera in the last parliament. As a Committee of National Security, we did our report. We actually went to that border, and we saw the challenges, because despite the gate being closed, I think people are just moving in and out. And as Governor has said, we are losing a lot of opportunities as a country and as a county. And especially even in terms of security. If that place is closed, there is more reason why people can use the porous border and bring other illegal things and also dangerous weapons that are going to be used in this country. So I think we did our report as a committee and we tabled in the House, and we have said as much that the border needs to be opened, and it's really, really very important. And I think, as Governor said, that is the reason why they are not even able to generate enough revenue. If the border is open, a lot will be done for that country. So I think maybe the Senate National Security Committee, I'll share the same with the committee, and we need to relook into that matter. If need be, maybe we can visit Mandera again and see how we can be able to activate the same position so that we have the border open. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Senator. Governor, as the chair of a committee within the Council of Governors, the message I'd like you to take back is that we want to encourage closer collaboration. We ought not to be meeting only when we've summoned you. And the meeting in Kakamega cannot be called a meeting. That one was a rally. So we can't say that we meet at the devolution conference. I want to encourage joint committee meetings. You chair a committee. Let's have a situation where your committee can then approach a committee of Senate and you sit jointly. It might not have a framework in law, but it is useful because it helps us to look at these issues. At the very minimum, and this I've shared with your colleagues, at the very minimum, I'd like to have a meeting between the COG and Senate for us to redefine a better way of carrying out oversight. This report that we are looking at is supposed to be looked at by your county assembly at the primary level. But here we are looking at the same report. We come up with different recommendations, different findings. I believe that the county assembly should look at the transactions, whereas the Senate should look at the intelligence behind some of the decisions that you have undertaken. So please send that message back, that we crave for closer interactions outside IBEC, outside the devolution conference, outside parliamentary summons.
Thank you, Chair. I think the first term of devolution was characterized by a lot of suspicion and that issue. But the second term, the same spirit is being shared by most of the governors that are at COG. And I lead the same mindset, you know, in terms of jointly we can achieve a lot for Kenya if we can work together. And the mechanism is there in law, Mr. Chair. The collaborative mechanism, consultation, is there entrenched in law, in the main constitution, that we'll be able to meet formally and engage as required. I will take that back. The goodwill is there now within the national government and the county governments, and the current governors. We are 1 year into the second term of devolution, and so far, at least the spirit is good.
All right. So Ali Roba is currently before the Senate.